Hi, I'm Sandata Yet Villarreal Jr. Welcome to Visual Assisted Instruction Computer Programming 3 series. Right now we are on our Lecture 3 of week 1 to 4. Now let's proceed to our topic for today. So our topic for today is about the flowchart. A flowchart is a diagram that depicts a process, system, or computer algorithm. They are widely used in multiple fields to document, study, plan, improve, and communicate often complex processes in clear and easy to understand diagrams. Flowchart use rectangle, oval, diamond, and numerous other shapes to define the type of step, along with connecting arrows to define the flow and sequence. Now, as a student, you need to create your own algorithm first before you can do the flowchart. Okay, so the idea is that if you create your algorithm, then you can diagram the idea that you create into a flowchart. And there are many kinds of flowcharts we have into different aspects of studies. Now, let's proceed to the next slide. Flowcharts are sometimes called by more specialized names such as process flowchart, process map, functional flowchart, business process mapping, business process modeling and notation, process flow diagram. So they are similar to each other, but they have different specialization. For example, if you're a BSBA, of course, what flowchart you're going to use is a business process mapping. And it is the same as the flowchart in IT or computer science. So for another example is that if you are taking up accountancy, then your flowchart is considered to be an accounting flowchart. Okay, so next. There are types of flowchart we have in computer. First, document flowchart. Second, data flowchart. Third, system flowchart. Fourth, program flowchart. And five, workflow flowchart. Now let's itemize this and define those five types of flowcharts we have. So document flowchart, these have the purpose of showing existing controls over the document flow through the components of a system. The chart is read left to right and documents the flow of documents through the various business units. So document flowchart can be considered as all of your documents to where it goes and what is the direction of the documents you are gathering. And that is how the document flowcharts work. For example, you are creating an algorithm. You are going to document what you are doing. Then after that, you get the positive result. Then you can document on it. That's why it is called document flowchart. So figure 1 shows the example and uses of document flowchart. So we have here the document management process flowchart. General manager, they're going to do is to sign an issue. We have here the deputy, grand manager, okay, right here, approval. So these are considered to be the document flowchart. Where does the document goes upon the completion of the required individual file? Next, data flowchart. This shows the control of governing data flows in a system. These are used primarily to show the channels that the data is transmitted through the system rather than how controls flow. Now, data flowchart is something like if you gather a data, where does data go and what is the avenue of the data by transmission and what are the changes from the data when you put it into the account going through the other parts of the process. In figure 2 shows the example and uses of data flowchart. So we have here the student, extra note, payments, and it will go to management and the management bills the student. The manager, item needed each day, then perishable items, then we have the vendor, secretary, going to management again, then we have chief warden, overdue payments. Okay, that's the figure of a data flowchart. Next, we have the system flowchart. This shows the flow of data to and through the major components of a system, such as data entry, programs, storage media, processor, and communication network. So we are very familiar with the system flowchart because it talks about system. For example, that is a computer system. So what is the flow of data if you're going to use the computer system? Of course, we have the keyboard, the mouse, the processor, the motherboard, the video, audio, and the cameras. So those are parts of the system. Now let's check out the example right here. So in figure 3 shows the example and uses of system flowchart. And the system is speed sensor. So it goes too fast. If yes, less fuel to engine. And go back again to sensor. If it's too fast, no. Too slow. If yes, more fuel to engine. If no, it will go back to the speed sensor. Next, we have the program flowchart. This shows the controls placed internally to a program within a system. And we have here in figure 4 shows the example and uses of program flowchart. So this is a program of job hiring process. There are plenty to be considered if you're going to make a flowchart in a complete program. But if it is considered to be part by part, then you can finish that exactly easily. Next, we have the workflow chart. The workflow flowchart. To document workflows, often involving tasks, documents, and information in offices. A workflow diagram depicts a series of actions that defines a job or how work should be done. Okay, so it talks about what you're going to do. Okay, if you hire as a programmer, and that is your workflow flowchart. If you're a student, what you're going to do as a student every day that you have a class and without a class. In figure 5 shows the example and uses of workflow flowchart. This is how it works. So start, obtain carbon elsewhere, yes or no. Yes, it goes to energy from light. Yes, photoheterotroph. If no, energy from inorganic oxidation. If yes, chemoheterotroph. And if no, heterotroph. Obtain carbon elsewhere. No, energy from light. Yes, photoautotroph. If no, energy from inorganic oxidation. If yes, chemoautotroph. If no, autotroph. So that is the flow. Next, we have the flowchart symbols. So we have 9. Terminal or terminator, process, decision, document, data or input, output, stored data, flow arrow, comment or annotation, on page connector. So we have here the figure or the identification of it. Terminal or terminator, so we have the oval or pill shape represents the start and end. Process, the rectangle shape represents a process. Decision, the diamond shape represents a decision. Document, data or input, output, the parallelogram shape represents input, output of the information. Stored data, it can be modified also like this. Next, we have the flow arrow, the direction. The arrow shape represents the flow of the sequence. Comments or annotation. And the last one is the on-page connector. So if it is more than one page, you can put circle and you can insert letter as A. Then on the other page, you can put A also. So that connects each other on the page. Congratulations! You successfully finished our lecture number 3. Thank you and good luck.